This was a very interesting game. I think that you were very close to lose this game.
Very,
very. Very, like this, like this. It was like this. I think the 40th, his 40th move instead of c3 when he allowed you to push on d5.
Actually, after queen e4 d5, I might still be lost, but queen f7 was winning on the spot, in fact.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then, of course, I should have played rook c5. I mean, I should have repeated moves.
Mm-hmm.
But I was not happy about it. But okay, maybe we can look at the whole game.
Yes, of course. We should look at the whole game. Okay, I will make the moves. And sometimes you can say something, or I will put some questions, something like that. Okay. e4, c5, knight f3, d6, d4, cd4, knight xd4, knight f6, knight c3,
yes,
a6.
I was in a good mood, so, okay, I mean...
Yes, you play usually this kind of variation, Sicilian.
Well, but not only, I mean, when I want to play safe, I don't play this.
Yes, of course, this is
but
yeah,
I was
very,
just,
very
I just thought, okay, it's the beginning of the tournament, I should try to play interesting games from the beginning, and then okay, if I feel tired, then I will play some safer lines. But yeah, okay, it's first round, so if I'm not feeling good in the first round, then it's kind of tricky.
Okay, bishop g5, e6,
yeah,
f4.
I was expecting bishop g5, but mm-hmm. I forgot to look at it.
Aha,
yeah,
but
h6 usually plays bishop e3.
h6 is the last. Latest trend. Important game is Aix-les-Bains, Nisipeanu Wojtaszek.
Yeah.
But then this was the poison pawn was accepted, and in this game it was not.
Yeah. That's well, I didn't have the choice.
That's the difference. Okay.
Yeah.
Bishop h4, queen
b6.
Okay, now.
Okay, I mean, just to summarize the idea of playing h6 before queen b6, I mean, just to get a poison pawn variation without allowing some lines and so on. I mean, I'm not a specialist, but this is what I know about it. But of course, after when you include h6, bishop h4, some lines like a3 are already a bit more tricky to handle, I mean, like we saw. Here I just missed bishop c4, in fact, after knight d7, with always the idea of bishop
okay,
c6.
let's say
knight
at c6 least a3 now, it's a safe move now, you cannot take on b2.
Yeah.
That's the first difference comparing to the game Nisipeanu-Wojtaszek, where this...
No, I think I should have played knight c6. I mean, I almost played knight
yes.
c6 on the
yes.
spot.
This was
I thought knight d7 was tricky.
In fact, we were analyzing this knight c6. Oh, I have to go back instead, and we arrived to something like queen b6, a3, now queen c6. We arrived here until this position, which is completely equal.
I thought not knight h6, but bishop f2 was...
Okay, bishop f2 also.
No,
but
because knight c6 I can take with the pawn, I guess.
Different move order, sorry. With different move order. First this, and then when you take,
okay, yes,
then this, then you have to take probably with the queen. Otherwise, this structure is...
No, I'm used to play this pawn take c6, is just better for black.
Ah, then knight d5.
Yeah.
Aha, so you mean. Okay. Okay, everything is clear. B takes c6. Okay.
Knight c6. I have this position when I play knight c6.
You were bishop f2 like in the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And queen c7 is more or less forced.
More or less forced. Mm-hmm.
And then I thought I was doing fine, but...
Now you have a shevening in looking position.
Yeah. But the bishop on f2 is not doing so many things, and then I just saw bishop d7, bishop 7.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's a reasonable game.
Yes,
we can
of course,
play
a normal
on.
Game.
Okay, I mean, there's no point of analyzing so closely, but I mean, I should have played this. After knight d7, I was only expecting queen f3, which in fact was a very interesting option also.
After knight bd7, you were expecting knight f3?
Queen f3.
Aha, this knight is not hanging because of bishop f2.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the idea, okay, I mean, I might
okay.
have to take some mouse here. So queen f3. So of course, I mean, if you play this, there's no
way to... Yes, it's connection. That is connected.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you, so can, I mean, you can make everything you want.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, because of this pawn, So this is the bad news.
So actually, what is the good news?
I had seen this, queen h3, and still, you know, just...
Yes, still hanging.
Yeah.
Desperately hanging.
Here, I mean, the real idea, because, okay, queen g4 is just a cheap trick. I mean, that this is also very close to lost. So, at least, I mean, I saw g5, and yeah, at least you have this. And okay, I mean, this is very
time
dangerous.
Is a your queen is a big trouble.
Well, I mean, I just gave it up, and I have rook and bishop and two pawns, but it looks very dangerous for instance of this.
But underdeveloped and...
Quite. No, this is so in fact I was going to play this, which is very interesting line, but also very, very dangerous. On castle. Okay, here's the idea that this...
Knight d5,
So here have queen d6, rook takes, and pawn takes. Takes f6, and it's not clear what I'm doing, because I mean after this knight d5 I'm already lost, I guess. So, and also after this there's very tricky line. Rook takes, bishop f4, queen takes, pawn takes, knight d5, and
not so quick, because you know our
I mean what
our spectators are not so.
Yeah, but it's very convincing.
Not anyway. Such experts.
Yeah, okay. I mean, my only idea was a deflection. I mean, just to have this dick checked, which wins the queen. But the problem is that here it's close to mate.
Yes. Very dangerous. Looks very dangerous.
It this looks position. Very much lost also. So here, yeah, this was not an option. So I saw g5, bishop f2. Queen c7, until we were analyzing bishop b5, in fact, after the game. Which I only saw there, and I mean, it's a fucking mess.
This is it's fucking looks mess very dangerous for you.
Yeah. Also, after queen c6, the problem is that there's knight d5, I mean, and you basically win a tempo over queen c7. So, I don't know. I mean, it's a mess.
Now usually, white has such a position with piece down after sacrificing a piece. Now he has this position.
No, but also, I mean, it's
without any sacrifice
but
at all.
I have to say that modern chess is very concrete. I mean, if white or if black holds this, then it can be very good. So, I mean, you have to also to look at this, which is quite disgusting looking. But I mean, at least this knight is hanging. On the diamond, you're just basically wanting to take on f4, knight e5. I mean, there are very similar games. Like, I don't remember Wang Yue won one game in very similar fashion. I mean, some bishop c4, bishop f7. I mean, really some tall stuff in Chinese Championship, if I remember well. So, I mean, anyway, this was. I mean, you anyway getting such positions with knight or so. I mean, I was not surprised, but I was also not trying to calculate too long, because I mean, it's first it's useless, second it's actually wasting
time
and wasting energy.
If your time and energy, if your opponent will not go for this line, then it's all in vain.
Yeah. So g5 was. G5 was basically the only move. I mean, I just missed that bishop c4.
Yes, threatening bishop c6. Thematical.
Yeah. Of course, if queen e7, just queen e2, and I look really ridiculous. So. Okay, g5. I mean, I was already happy that after bishop. Okay, I mean, pawn takes g5 is not a move to look at. I mean, bishop f2 is, of course, principled. Then
we looked actually in this take queen c5 here, bishop f6, knight f6,
black,
you have excellent compensation.
No, I mean, this is like with you play it with end, I mean, if you get this position. So of course bishop f2 is the only move, queen c7. Yes, and yeah, okay, I mean, I was happy that at least here I have this queen c4, which basically holds everything.
Yes. Yes, of course.
So queen e2 was move. Okay, knight b6, because here, I mean we looked at the same lines more or less. So I mean this is extremely dangerous, because I mean if you taking f7, then knight takes f4. I mean it's
so this two pawns for
this
the
bishop
piece
sacrifice
and
is
king.
I mean more than classical in Sozin. So I mean which is basically bishop c4 after knight of defense, and then you get in this and okay bishop d4 is just the idea that knight e5 loses to b4, and so you have to take care of your queen,
yes,
and take care of your
trapping the queen with b4.
So king
yes.
f7 looks like, I mean, maybe not the only move, but I mean at least extremely logical. And then I mean white is just castling, and I mean I'm already thinking if I should resign here.
Yes, very very bad king. Two pawns for the piece, and now
yeah, very active pieces. Yeah.
Either long this castle
is,
or short castle.
Unpleasant, yeah.
Yes, very unpleasant.
No, unpleasant. I mean, I'm sure
okay.
It's plus
no,
two.
No, knight b6 is okay.
Yeah, bishop b3 also is...
Bishop b3, yes, now you took.
Long castle.
Long
yes,
castle.
Yeah, I was thinking if I should play e5 first, but okay. As I saw that, I mean, at least this is not working at all for white. Because I was looking at shit like this. But it was never
yes.
working, so... Because you just basically do something like this and you're very safe.
Mm-hmm.
So q1 is quite a good move. G8. Yes, here I didn't even look at this, and it seems that I was right. As okay, Fabiano pointed out to me that knight f5
yes,
was just
one of typical.
Yeah. Which okay, I'm not surprised. I mean, anyway, bishop d7 didn't occur to my mind. To be truthful. No, g8 is just principled. I mean, I just wanted to. Okay, pawn takes also. Because here, if he takes with the pawn, then knight g4 and already, I mean, with
yes,
the knight on e5, I'm very comfortable.
Of course.
No, yes. So bishop g3. And okay, I mean, this was my idea that to keep bishop away from f2, or he can take on b6. That's why I play g5.
One question, just in this moment. Can you play now this maneuver knight g4?
I
knight
thought
e5?
About it.
It's too slow?
I thought e5.
You saw something, yes.
I thought
if probably you saw something.
Actually, maybe I'm wrong because I missed such here. I thought I was lost, but in fact I have bishop g5 check, which I missed.
And you have a square, now you have square e7 for a kick.
Yes, I'm queen f7. I missed. Well, I mean, even this could be dangerous, but I mean, at least it's... So maybe
okay.
knight g4 is an option, but I thought... Okay, enough emotions, enough heartbeats.
Okay.
So
okay.
e5 is very
okay.
safe, even if, of course, I'm slightly worse here already. Also, I missed this idea, because here I started to play very precise moves. I mean, because I was thinking maybe I could play rook d3 to prevent castling. And then I thought...
How it prevents... because there's something
knight
on
b5.
The third, knight b5 and rook c3 is threatening, yes.
Actually, it was not true, it was preventing, but I mean, I was very uncomfortable. But I thought maybe knight c4, or I don't remember if it was knight d7, but at least I thought I was having some options.
But this looks yes, unpleasant.
Yeah, no, but king b1 is very strong, because in fact you don't have to prevent castling. Because yeah, I just missed that after king b8, queen e3, I'm on the verge of losing simply. Because I just missed. The queen was coming to a7, I guess. I mean, I just missed this.
No, of course, but if you go to c8, what's happening?
Yeah, just knight, just playing with pieces.
Yes, of course, very strong bishop, like in the game. This
yep.
bishop was all the time.
Yeah,
very
but
very
I mean, like in the game, but in a much, 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 much worse version.
You think this is much worse version than in the game?
Well, I mean.
Somehow I prefer
painful.
This version than that in the queen.
No, this is just reasonable. I mean, if you want, we can start some analyzing.
No. We should know.
Yeah.
We should not bother you so long.
Yeah, but I'm sure that it's winning. I mean, I'm sure that the computer will sell plus 150 or something at least. Maybe not, because you will find a defense, but I won't find so. I mean,
okay.
Why was that? No, rook d7 is... Well, I mean, I was happy that I was not...
But you are now losing your pawn back.
Yeah, but I mean, at least my pieces were solid. I thought, okay, it could be worse. It could have been much worse. That's what I thought. So okay, I mean, because this is normal. So king b8 is forced because okay, rook takes f7, queen c4 check.
Yes.
So king b8. Okay, he would just okay, I just pass this move because it's not the most interesting part. Okay, except yes, that h5 was with quickly. The idea of rook g4, which was okay, surprisingly very strong and very unpleasant to face. So I mean, h3 is good move. Queen g5, queen f3. Here I just played h4 for no reason because I want. Ah no, there was a reason because rook c5, there was bishop d5. I mean, this was a good reason not to play it. Ah, yeah. This was very unpleasant.
So you have to go back and then.
Yeah, because rook takes d5. I'm not sure, but I guess rook takes d5 is just almost winning. Some queen g84 and bullshit, but it doesn't work, so I mean, I'm just close to lost here. So that's why I played h4. Rook e3, okay, here already bishop d5 doesn't work anymore. I don't remember why, but I know it didn't work at all.
No, it's knight takes, rook takes, and hanging, rook in e3 is hanging, yes.
Yeah, so knight e4 is very strong anyway. Here I was going to resign maybe, but then I noticed that after rook g4 I have e4, which...
No, again, if you manage to trade your passed pawn for his passed pawn, it's...
Yeah, it's the worst is over.
The worst is over, yes, exactly.
Yeah, so rook g4, queen g7 is first, then I missed queen d3, which is quite strong. Queen d7 was the only move to keep fighting. Okay, my idea was after queen a6 to play e4 and, I mean...
To activate.
Yeah, I mean, because then you don't have much time to think. I mean, the bishop is not doing so well after d5 already. I mean, my pieces are active. I mean, it could actually be not that bad. I mean, of course it's worse, but it's not that bad. Which was all I was looking for in this position. So, rook b6 is... Okay, rook c6. Here I was just having... blind side because of course Fabiano rejected bishop a4 because of queen f7 check, which is
but there is some good, is, but is there some b6 e4 is there some e4 yes
yeah this is winning
yes
yeah I mean surprisingly enough this is winning because I mean you're just queen in the pawn
cannot, yes, cannot stop I mean, the pawn anymore
and this I think I was calculating this and I thought okay I mean, this should be lost. I mean, even if you have queen h6, you play e3, and I mean, this king is quite uncomfortable.
Safe, yes. Black's king is safe, and the pawn is going, and you must be very careful where to put your queen, because
this is lost in
some fact, checks, discovered checks.
Yeah. No, I mean, so I played rook c6 just for this trick, bishop a4, and then I will, and of course, I mean, there was even the basics, queen f7, but of course I would have taken on b6. Actually, rook b4. Yeah, I should have repeated moves. Because also after this is also a very nasty trick. I mean, to basically lose positions like
losing material. White is losing material. Yes.
I mean, not f6 queen takes c6 check. This was the thing. So okay, this was quite tricky. I mean, if you're you just don't want to lose this game with white. I mean, obviously you don't want to. So
no, even after rook rook c5.
Yeah, I should have repeated moves because queen c7 was losing. Rook c5, and actually maybe I'm some more. Okay, I wouldn't say holding because it's obvious
threat,
I'm much
the
worse.
The threat is d5, so he must play something like bishop d5.
Yeah, and then rook d5.
Ah, you want to exchange rooks.
Yeah.
That's very important for you, because otherwise there is a pressure against bishop f6.
Actually, I'm not sure about this endgame, because maybe this endgame should be lost, in fact.
After b4, yes.
Yeah, this should be lost.
Very difficult endgame, maybe lost. Because this...
yeah, because of this...
These pawns are...
I mean, white will play c4,
very far, I mean, far away, one c4, for
mm-hmm. Then, okay, change the pawn and play, get a passed pawn on a6 and just...
Passed pawn on a5, on a line, of course. And there are two far away, one from another.
Yes, and my pawns are blocked here just because of this. Mm-hmm. So this is just lost.
Mm-hmm.
This is just lost. In fact, after bishop d5, I was just trying some shit like this. But okay,
now just c3, d4. And then this is not needed still. C3 is not still needed. Still
yeah,
not needed.
This is probably lost.
Yes, this is probably
no, lost. No, so queen c7, I played. Mm-hmm. Okay, here I just see some. Yeah, queen d5 is of course strong, and then I mean I can just resign. I mean,
yes.
Queen c8. I mean, queen f7 is just resigning. Because I mean, if you take on f5, b4, b6, take. No, bishop d5 is even stronger. Quite painful.
Yes, you are losing a piece actually.
Well, I'm not sure yet, but okay. I mean, I just. Mm-hmm. I won't survive this for sure.
Aha, you go for the king.
Yeah, but I won't.
You go with the king.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I go with the king, but I'm sure I'm not surviving, so.
Probably not.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I don't even want to look at this. I mean,
no, this is immediately. The queen b7 and c3. Okay. It's over. You cannot prevent the queen c6 mate.
No, queen takes d5 check.
A queen is already, king is already on c5, yes.
So that's why bishop b7 is winning.
Right. Mm-hmm. Bishop b7 is winning, yes.
Yeah, so, I mean, queen f7 was winning, queen e4, d5. Okay, I played it with 2 seconds on the clock, or three, mm-hmm. Whatever.
This was the last move, before the control.
Yeah, but I was hesitating to see if I had another option, but I didn't see, so I thought, okay, d5 and see what happens next. So bishop takes d5 was quite strong.
Mm-hmm. We were analyzing a little bit, bishop d5 and queen, bishop takes b7.
Why, I didn't check queen e3 check, but I guess queen c5 is... maybe queen e3 check, but okay, bishop takes b7. And this is very close to lost, in fact.
Now we tried e4.
No, but this is
this lost. Doesn't work. This is worst. You think so? Ah, king b, yes.
Yeah.
And rook endgame is lost, of course.
Yeah, completely lost.
Completely lost, yes.
No, so this was very close to lost. And I don't understand why he didn't play this. I mean, I was just expecting it so much. And then I saw it was sinking, and I was okay.
But I think that he was already aware that he missed something.
Yeah.
Something forced, and this is...
Yeah, this is an unpleasant situation.
Unpleasant situation, yes.
Especially as it happened to him also last year mm-hmm. against me, but... still, I mean, this is, I mean, it's move 41, so, I mean, if you're thinking a bit, you realize, I mean, he just didn't realize that this endgame was extremely unpleasant.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, probably lost, because, I mean, the idea is just to get back the bishop on e1, the mm-hmm. king is not comfortable at all. So, when he took the queen, I was just...
You were happy.
More relieved than happy.
Much more than happy.
No, I said more relieved than happy. Because, okay, I mean, just a chess game, so, I mean, it's not... Okay, of course, it's influencing your mood if you lose badly, but, I mean, at least he had played quite well, so, I mean, he deserved to win, which is a good reason to not to be devastated by a loss. So, C3, he had much more painful run. Much more painful loss.
Yes.
In the last, all my last losses would have been much more painful than if I had lost this game, because he had played really strong and confidently and very precise. And she just started collapsing completely with queen f7. Mm-hmm. And then after if I thought maybe I'm better, but okay. In fact, he's holding. Also, in fact, this might be a miracle too. In e6, and she had. Don't see anything better because rook c6, rook e2 is holding by a fucking mill. So I don't see anything better than rook e3 than queen f6. And this is an easy draw.
And this is a dead draw, of course.
Yeah. Well, I mean, not completely dead.
Completely.
Yeah, completely.
This is not.
Yeah, completely.
No, no weakness in.
Yes, in fact, you can even at some point look to the bishop, I guess. Against
it's a dead draw.
Yeah. Yeah, but rook g7. Okay, here I played queen b6 for one last trick. Rook b6, rook g8. So looking at this, rook d6, bishop d5, and I have to go back, and it's a draw by repetition. So, which is why I played queen b6, because, okay, at least I have this stupid trick which wins on the spot. Because, okay, it takes queen f2, check, queen e1. So, if you place this queen c3 and mate.
And mate, yes.
So, queen c2 is forced. And, okay, actually, I didn't calculate that far. I mean, I only calculated that this should be a win. I'm confident that it is, and the taking c1, okay, I thought, whatever. I don't know, maybe this, maybe something else, but okay, this looks quite difficult for white. I'm sure that white won't go through it unscathed. Yes, this is okay, something should be lost. So I mean, anyway, I mean, it's at least drawn. Okay, it could be lost, but okay. Of course, if I'm rook g2, which basically is holding, and okay, I was just too tired to think if I can keep on playing, but I guess not, because it's okay. I mean, my pawn is on e3, which is a huge improvement, but at least it's very solid. I mean, there's no attack at all.
So he played after rook b6. He played rook g8.
No, I played queen b6.
Ah, you played queen b6. Yes, of course. So this is, aha.
Yeah, and actually I was looking at this pretty line to just finish the game in some fashion.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, Maxim.
Okay, thank you.